Welcome to this video for finding books on musical topics in the library. This video covers how to access and use the library catalog to search for books. I'll provide some examples of how to find music biographies, and I'll show you some tips on how to evaluate books for your research. For many types of music sources, you will need to do a search in the library catalog. The catalog is an online search tool that searches the contents of the library collections. It includes things like books, ebooks, music scores, sound recordings, and links to databases. It also includes titles of journals, but it does not include individual journal articles. To search for journal articles, you'll need to go to a journal database. To get to the library catalog, simply go to the library homepage at library.usask.ca and then click on the Library Catalog link at the center of the page. It's located under the search box. Many people get the library catalog mixed up with the search box at the center of the library homepage, but these are actually two different search tools. Because of some of the challenges of searching for musical resources, I tend to recommend the library catalog for most music research of library collections. The library has thousands of books on musical topics. One of the largest areas of books in the library are music biographies. These are books that talk about an individual's life and work. Biographies make an excellent starting place for research on a composer or a piece of music. They usually offer a comprehensive look at the topic, while also including more focused information as well. The library contains books for a variety of audiences, including scholars, students, and the general public. Generally, you will benefit from using scholarly or academic books for doing research for an academic paper. When you're using a biographical book, check to see if it has a bibliography or a works cited list at the end of either each chapter or at the end of the book. This is a great place to find more research resources on your topic. Most scholarly and academic books will have an index that's located at the back of the book. This is a tool that can help you to locate specific information on a topic or on a piece of music within that book. For example, if I was researching the Moonlight Sonata by Beethoven, I might find a biography of Beethoven and then use the index at the back of the book to look up the Moonlight Sonata. You can use the page numbers after the term in the index to see where that piece is mentioned in the book. Let's do a search for a biography in the library catalog now. First of all, you will need to go to the library homepage and then click on the link for the library catalog. I'm showing you how to use the library catalog because, generally, it returns more consistent results for music research, and searches in the library catalog can be more easily modified. When you get to the library catalog, go to the Advanced Search button. On this page, we're going to do a search for a subject. So you're going to need to click Subject from the drop-down menu, and then we're going to enter the term that we want to search for. Today I'm going to look for books on Beethoven. So I'm going to type in his name. When you're typing in your search terms here, make sure to check the spelling of the name or of the term. The catalog will not guess what you want if you use the wrong spelling. If you've done a search and you haven't found any items on your topic, go back and check that the spelling of your search terms is correct. If you're searching for someone's name as a subject, as we are here, then you need to do an inverted form of the name with the last name and then a comma and then the first name. This is how names are formatted in the library catalog. Then you just need to hit enter or click the go button. This page shows us our search results. At the top of the page you can see that we found over 300 results with Beethoven as a subject. As you look at the results, you're going to see some important information about each item. First you have the title, and then you have the name of the author of the book, and then some information about the publisher and the year it was published, and a little bit of information about how long this source is. The other thing you'll want to notice is this icon on the left-hand side. This icon tells us the format of the book. In this case, this is a printed book that you can find in the library. Under location, you can tell where this item is held in the physical library. In this case, This book is in the Murray Library. If you were searching in the physical library, you would want to jot down the call number and use this to find the book on the shelf. However, if you're working from home, you can request this item for pickup by clicking this blue button at the center of the page. If you request an item for pickup, it usually just takes a few days to have the book ready for you to pick up on campus. Now, given that we have over 300 results in this list, you may want to modify the results to narrow them down a little bit. If you ever want to modify your search, you can click the Modify Search button at the top center of the page. So I've clicked that Modify Search button, and maybe what I want to do is just limit to ebooks or electronic books. So I'm actually going to find that under this drop-down menu for location. I'm going to select electronic book and then hit enter. From here you can click on any title to get more information about the book and to get to the online full text. Once you've gotten to this page for the book, you might want to scroll down. There's some important information here, including a summary of the book, and sometimes you'll even find a table of contents. This can be really helpful for determining whether this book might be relevant to your topic. If you think this is a book that you want to read, go up to the top of the page and click this link that says Connect to the Online Version. From here, each ebook might look slightly different depending on which platform it's been published on. Usually, you'll have the option to see a table of contents as you do here, and usually you can navigate right to specific chapters of the book. You often also have the option to download a PDF. Some of our ebooks can only be viewed by one person at a time. So once you're done reading an ebook, please close your browser window so that others might be able to see the same book if they're searching at the same time as you. One of the things I want to point out about this ebook is on the left-hand side of the page. Here we have a table of contents with links, so you can always jump to another section of the book. I also want to point out this link at the bottom called End Matter. Here is where you are going to find a bibliography. This will be useful for finding related research on your topic. And we have an index. You can use this index to find information on specific pieces or specific topics within the book. Just to review, here are some tips for searching for books in the library catalog. Make sure to use the advanced search option so that you can add on limiters, like limiting to ebooks. When you're searching for books on a topic, you want to make sure to use a subject search. If you've done a search and you're not finding very much on your topic or you've gotten no results, you might want to go back and verify the spelling of your search terms. And finally, make sure to keep your search really simple. Only type one or two terms, and if you're using a name, make sure to invert the name with the last name and then a comma and then the first name. Just like other information sources, you will need to ensure that the books you're using for your research are reliable and relevant to your topic. The books you'll find in the library are written for a variety of purposes, and not all of them will necessarily be right for your research. Take time to identify why the book was written. Is it meant to inform the reader or persuade them of a particular opinion? Is it meant to entertain, to instruct, or to give an overview of the topic? You will also need to identify the audience of the book. Was it written for general readers who have only a basic understanding of musical topics? Was it written for students, or for specialists, or for music scholars? For research for an academic paper, you're likely to want to use books that are aimed at a scholarly or specialist audience. You'll also want to look for the publisher of the book. This information should be inside the front cover of a printed book, or in an online book, it should be included on the page where you access the ebook. You might be able to tell right away that it's published by a university press, or you might find books that are published by a commercial publisher, by a professional association, a government, or some of them might even be self-published. Generally, books by an academic press will be more scholarly in nature, while commercial publications have a range of purposes including entertainment, instruction, or study. Self-published works can be interesting. Some of them might be less reliable because they have not gone through an editing process at all, However, if you're reading an autobiography that was self-published, you might consider it reliable because it's a reflection of that person's own life and perspectives. You'll need to check who the author of the book is, what are their credentials, and where is their expertise. Often you can find the author biography on the back page of the book or in the first few pages. You'll also want to check if the author has cited their sources and if they included a bibliography or notes section of the book. If you find that information, it shows you that the research relies on the expertise of others in the field and is likely more scholarly. Finally, you'll want to look for the date of publication. The publication date is usually printed on the inside of the cover page in a printed book. In an ebook, this information should be on the page that you use to access the ebook. When considering the currency of the publication, you're going to want to consider whether there might be more recent research on the topic, and you might want to consider whether the book is out of date. On the other hand, an older publication might hold a more authoritative position in the research conversation if others have cited it heavily in their subsequent publications. This video introduced you to some information on how to access and use the library catalog. I provided some examples of how to search for biographies in the library, and some tips for how you can evaluate books for your own research.